Chief Mapet Central here. Heard some big news on the web today. EA is the new Netflix of video games. The Netflix of video games! How can that be? I don't subscribe to Netflix. I don't know a whole lot about it. But the thing I do know, I'm pretty sure they have more than 5 movies, right? Yeah, in fact, they have like hundreds and hundreds of movies. And I understand the comparison to this. We're all talking about the subscription thing. EA now has a subscription. You can subscribe to EA Games, and it's going to be available on the Xbox One. It's kind of an interesting thing because for $5, you get 5 games. $5 a month, you get 5 games. Okay. $8 a month on Netflix, and you get, well, I don't know, hundreds, thousands, whole ton of movies. So there's sort of a discrepancy there, but really what it comes down to is, what do you own? You go to the store, you buy a game, what do you own these days? Now back in the day when I was first buying Atari cartridges, go down to the store, you pick up a little Dig Dug cart like this, you just bring it home, fire it into your 2600, and you were good to go. You could play that game anytime you wanted. And that's kind of convenient, because it was yours. You bought it, you owned it, you had this physical game. How about Asteroids? Same thing. Yes, indeed. But games have really taken on sort of a new thing these days. And the PC gamers have been used to this for a long time. They've bought digital copies of things for years and years, and they don't seem to have a problem with it. And that's cool. But really, the console people, that's kind of a big switch. Because you have a console, it's kind of like a boat anchor until you put a disc into it, right? It really comes down to ownership. And where this first started for me was with music. I love music, I love all kinds of music, and I love my music on CDs. I don't mind MP3s. I'll rip a couple of my discs, make some little mix discs and stuff like that, put some of my favorite tracks onto a disc and listen to it, you know, that sort of thing. But I do not own an iPod. Never have, never will. I don't really see the value in that. I don't really ever go anywhere where I'm like, wow, if only I had brought 20 million songs with me, this would be great. Just doesn't happen. You know, I'm a disc man. I'm happy to bring that along, a couple of discs, you know. I jump in the car, have a CD player in there. I'll bring a couple of discs. I don't need millions of songs in my car. Say I do own gigs and gigs and gigs of music. In fact, if I were to rip all my CDs, I'll bet I would have quite a lot in terms of that kind of mass storage. But it's all mine. I have it right here. This whole cloud thing with music, everyone's like, ooh, it's in the cloud. I can listen to it on my tablet, on my phone, on my da-da-da-da-da. What if you're just out and about and, you know, somewhere there's not a net connection? And I know a lot of you that are thinking, you know, where could you possibly be where you wouldn't have an internet connection? Let me tell you about this place that's near my house. You might have something similar near your house, but near my house, we have this thing, it's called outdoors. It's called outside sometimes. It's not inside. You can see the sun and, you know, the air is fresher, that sort of thing. Outside, you do not always have Wi-Fi, broadband, whatever it is. And there's just this whole thing of ownership, which is really where the whole EA subscription thing kind of, you know, comes into play in the sense that, what do I own? I go and I buy a game, what do I own? I bought Asteroids. This is the Asteroids I bought when I was a little kid. And actually, this is the Dig Dug I bought when I was a little kid as well. And they still work on the VCS that I bought, again, when I was a little kid. Bought all this probably when I was about 12, 13, somewhere in there. And I've still got it. Still works, thank God. But this is sort of what I grew up with gaming. And as you progress through consoles, it was really the same thing. And it wasn't until very recently that we start getting into this whole thing of, well, if I buy a game, where's my game? If I can't put it in my hand, where is it? It's in the cloud. In the cloud! Who owns this cloud? Some company owns this cloud. Company's doing well. They put a whole bunch of stuff in the cloud. They put so much stuff in the cloud bursts, and all that crap falls out of it. The business goes to hell. They file for bankruptcy. They disappear. Okay, quick. Where's my music? Where's my video games? Where's all my stuff now that was in your cloud? Because a cloud is this sort of this fluffy, happy, nice sort of a thing. It's a server farm. There's a building somewhere using up scads of electricity. They probably have an enormous generator. And they power all these servers that host all your stuff. And we like to think of as being, oh, up in the clouds. In the clouds, you know, like outside, where there often is not Wi-Fi. Out there. That kind of a cloud. So, really what I'm getting at is, I want to own something. I mean, to me, if I buy a game, put something in my hands. Not just the receipt. I want the game in my hand. I know I'm sounding like some antiquated, angry old man kind of a thing here, but you know, what it really comes down to is, when you buy something, you kind of expect to have something tangible that you can hold. Now, I've gotten a lot of DVDs where they give you sort of this cloud option where you can like access a code, and because you bought the DVD and you have this special code, you can then watch it on other devices. Okay, that sounds convenient, but I still have my DVD. I think with gaming, there's really a large segment of people that just aren't really ready to buy a game and not really have anything. I mean, even like with Virtual Console, on like the Wii, you know, when the Wii came out and I saw some of the games I could get on there with Virtual Console, I was just like, whoa, awesome, look at all this. So I started, you know, I got quite a few things. You know, I probably have, you know, close to 50 games on there, and then I'm starting to think, you know, if this Wii dies, what the hell happens to all my games? Yeah, they die too. Now, there is a way, in theory, of putting them onto a Wii U and sort of bringing them along, but, you know, I have a 2DS now, and it's the same kind of a thing. I find some games, like, hey, these are pretty cool, but what happens if my 2DS dies? You know, what happens? So I'm slowly sort of embracing this idea, but I don't really, I'm not quite into the whole thing of like a subscription where suddenly I own nothing. I bought a subscription. And even the Ouya's gone down this road. They have this interesting thing now where it's, I want to say it's $60 for a year. It's kind of a trial thing. I don't think they let too many people into it, but basically it's a subscription. So rather than buying game after game after game on the Ouya, they just say, hey, take all the games. You got them all. It's a subscription now. And you can play them all. And that's pretty cool in a way because they actually have like 800 games, not five. So that's at least interesting, but I don't know. Are you ready to buy games and not really get a game, but just sort of have the game that you can play and so forth? I mean, I guess with a game, it's a little different because, you know, I can download something from my 2DS from the eShop, and then anywhere I go with battery power, I can play that game. I don't really have to connect anything necessarily. But what about a lot of these games that do rely on a connection? You know, a lot of games, you know, you go up to, you have to log into them to play them, to play multiplayer and other things. I'm just wondering what happens when all that gets shut down for whatever reason, and suddenly, you know, that game isn't there that you really loved. Because if someone came to me today and said, hey, I know you've loved Asteroids, and it's a fun game, it's come out on a lot of platforms, but Asteroids has gone away. There is no more Asteroids. You know, that'd be like someone coming to me and saying, hey, there is no more Fast Times at Ridgemont High. It's like, what do you mean? I've got it on VHS, Laserdisc, DVD. There must be. Don't tell me that Netflix dropped something and now I can't watch it. Because isn't that the other thing that we hear about Netflix? Every now and then I'll be on some social network and I'll see this message saying, hey, do you love any of these 100 movies? Because watch them quick. They're going away. Going away? So I'm paying $8 for some random selection of movies that might just go away and disappear. So you can't even count on everything all the time. I mean, you've watched it once, but then it might not be there later. You just never know. It's this big sort of guessing game. Log into Netflix, see what's still there and available that you might want to watch. Well, that really sort of flies in the face of, you know, sort of the DVD model where I buy my movie, I can watch it whenever I want, many times as I want. Never disappears. And it just has a sort of sense of permanence. So for me, I'm not ready to make the leap. Could you tell? Could you tell I'm not really ready to make this leap into, wow, where'd all my stuff go from that cloud? But just as a whole thing, this whole idea of EA rolling out this thing where it's a subscription, and they compare it to Netflix, but they're really not very similar in terms of the numbers. You know, hundreds and hundreds of movies versus five games doesn't make for much of a comparison outside of it's a subscription. And the subscription means you get no physical media. You're just like an EA customer, and as soon as you stop paying, all the games go away. Maybe your internet connection goes down. All the games go away. Who's ready for this? Are you ready for this? I'm curious to know how many people out there are really ready to make this leap toward buying all your games digitally and really not having anything to show for it, aside from seeing them in a menu listing when you log into a service, whether you're on a console, your computer, or a handheld device of some kind. I don't know. I like to know what's mine. I know what's mine. Keep it retro, have fun, keep gaming, and make sure you have a physical copy of your game because there is nothing more rewarding than the feeling of a cartridge kind of, sort of, but not always quite lining up and then into the cartridge slot, and then you play an awesome 8-bit game. That's kind of how life should go. So, keep it retro, have fun, catch y'all later.